So we're here today at Clapham Junction Station in London. Since leaving UCL, I became a project engineer at Network Rail. And one of the key projects that I'm working on is managing flood risk here at the station. It's a really critical part of the network as it connects London with predominantly a lot of the southwest of the UK. As a client company that wants to establish a really sound performing railway system, it's really important that as climate change progresses, we're able to, you know, still provide train services through critical storm conditions.
My name is Maya and I graduated from UCL a year ago with a Bachelor's in Civil Engineering. Since graduating UCL, I have gone on to join the graduate program at Multiplex, which is a two-year program consisting of three different rotations. In my first rotation, I was involved in the new business department, where I was involved in winning work for the business. And now, as a graduate engineer, in my second rotation, I work on a project in Southbank.
So project engineer at Network Rail, it's a really varied job. Some days I can be in the office looking at design reports that other consultants produce, and then some days I can be out on site looking at the particular risks that we're trying to manage on the railway network. I lead a team of three people. Within that, we have a portfolio of projects that we deliver annually, and sometimes that can be reactive, and other days it can be for planned works.
A typical day for me involves carrying out a number of quality assurance checks on site to ensure that activities are occurring in accordance with risk assessment method statements, quality inspection test plans, and drawings that are assigned to that segment of work. I'll also support site walks when visitors come to site, as well as our weekly health and safety inspection. And lastly, I'll track progress on site through several KPI trackers so that when I update the team, I am able to tell them what has occurred on site and what we have to look forward to the next week.
The UCL course gave me a really sound understanding of a lot of engineering concepts, which I apply daily, whether that be when I'm reviewing retaining wall designs, drainage systems, or looking at slope stability. Another thing that was really important was the importance of how to draw. I find myself so often just jotting down little sketches or creating little whiteboards when I'm trying to explain difficult concepts to clients.
The standout module for me in preparing me for my current role would be the structures and materials module, but I gained an understanding of how to design columns, slabs and frames, as well as understanding how materials such as concrete react to environmental changes such as temperature variation, all of which is the knowledge I use when carrying out quality assurance checks.
So one of the highlights of my UCL degree was when we did the Constructionarium project in year two. In day-to-day work, you don't just walk into a job where you're managing a team of 20 people and delivering an engineering solution out on site. As a project manager at the time, that was probably the biggest opportunity to lead a team of people, learn how to motivate others, learn how to communicate to difficult clients, and overall, how you keep a project on track for successful completion.
What I loved about studying in the Department of Civil Engineering is the opportunity given to us to work with a wide variety of people from different backgrounds, allowing me to develop the skill of collaboration and communication, which is so highly valued by employers. In addition to this, the problem-based learning allowed me to develop the mindset and skill set required to tackle projects in the construction industry.
So as an engineer now, I really feel that we are solving global issues, particularly within the railway context. One of the most important things is that people are connected from a transport perspective. Being able to solve those issues is a really important challenge that we need not only address now, but then also continue to address in the future.